Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting off this video, we have a couple of launches to take a look at, starting with SpaceX's next commercial resupply mission with the CRS22 launch.
And liftoff of the 22nd SpaceX cargo resupply mission, bringing new solar arrays.
The booster, which was brand new on this mission, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Picture perfect landing of that Falcon 9 for the first stage. First landing for this first stage, 86 successful recovery overall for SpaceX.
Then, earlier in the day today, SpaceX launched yet another mission with the SXM-8 launch.
Zero. Ignition and liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B1061, landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
And we have touchdown of Falcon 9. Falcon 9 has just landed on our drone ship. Just read the instructions. Today marks the 87th overall successful recovery of an orbital class rocket, as well as SpaceX's 125th successful mission to date.
CRS-22's Dragon capsule arrived at the ISS a day or so after it launched. NASA tweeted on Saturday, contact and capture are confirmed at 5:09 a.m. Eastern Time. SpaceX's Cargo Dragon has arrived at the space station, delivering over 7,300 pounds of ISS research equipment, supplies and new rollout solar arrays for the orbiting lab. There is an article from Space News regarding some satellites on SpaceX's next dedicated rideshare mission. The article says, a pair of CubeSats built by General Atomics for the Space Development Agency will seek to demonstrate optical communications between satellites and from satellites to a military drone aircraft. The satellites are scheduled to fly to a sun-synchronous orbit later this month aboard a SpaceX Falcon 9 rideshare mission called Transporter 2. Whilst not directly related to SpaceX, it's worth mentioning the US Air Force has recently announced it is interested in sending cargo around the Earth using commercial rockets. This CNBC article says, called Rocket Cargo, the experimental military program will be led by the US Space Force, the Pentagon said. The program will research and help develop capabilities such as landing a rocket on a wide range of non-traditional materials and surfaces, engineering a rocket cargo bay and logistics for rapid loading and unloading, and airdropping cargo from the rocket after re-entry in order to service locations where a rocket or aircraft cannot possibly land. In Boca Chica, here's a view of the work on the orbital launch site tank farm. The crane for stacking the integration tower is being extended to stack more segments. Here's a great overview of the whole orbital launch site area. All the cap extensions for the orbital launch mount legs have been installed. At the propellant production site, the next vehicle integration tower segments are progressing. So too are the cryo tank shells for the GSC tanks at the orbital tank farm. In the production yard, crews are working on a new transport mount. Eric Ralph posted a couple of interesting tweets related to Starship. The first says, SpaceX is hiring a Starship medical engineer to design, integrate and implement a medical system of the future for Starship and provide medical support during flight operations. Then he posted, that sounds to me like future cruise Starships will have their own dedicated medical facilities. Hard for my sci-fi molded mind to not read between the lines of this post and see it as SpaceX attempting to develop a real-life spaceship medbay. Here's a view of the SN20 aft dome with vacuum raptor mounting points. The Super Heavy BN2.1 test tank was prepared over the last few weeks for testing. This test tank and stand have since been moved to the launch site to begin testing. Another section of Super Heavy BN3 has been moved into the high bay for stacking. The upper stack for the Super Heavy Booster No. 3 prototype was seen outside. As we always do, we will finish our Sunday video with the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Progress with SN20 and BN3 is coming along nicely as SpaceX look to get orbital as quickly as possible with Starship and Super Heavy. As always, I like to finish my videos by saying thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Girl who is out there all the time filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.